In this video, we will discuss concept of relational data model. We will also discuss the different component of the relational data model. But before discussing the concept of the relational data model, we are having the concept of the logical database design. Previously, we discussed concept of the conceptual data model. So the process of transforming conceptual data model into logical data model, that is called logical database design. While in conceptual database design, that is about to understand the organization, how the different components are connected with each other. What are the different components? What are the different entities having the different attributes or properties and having the relationship with each other? That is to understand the organization. While logical database design is about to creating the stable structure of the database. Now we are having the concept of relational data model. Relational data model is related to the logical database design. In relational data model, that was very first time introduced by Dr. E.F. Codd in 1970. Very first DBMS that was built on the relational data model was System R. Another DBMS that was based on the relational data model, the name of that one is Ingres. So what we have in relational data model? In relational data model, data is represented in the form of table, and relational data model are based on the mathematical relation. In relational data model, we are having the three main component. First one, we are having the data structures of the relational data model. In relational data model, data is organized in the form of tables with rows and columns. So when we see that relational data model is here, we are having the different tables are there that containing the different columns and rows. That is a relational data model. When we see that data manipulations, so to perform the different powerful operation like insertion, updation, deletion of the data. And third one, another component of the relational data model, that is our database or data integrity. To maintain the accuracy of the data in relational data model or in a table, we are having set of rules which ensure the correctness and accuracy of the data. We will discuss these things in detail. So first one, we say that we are having the concept of data structures. When we say that we are having the relation is available, relation is named two-dimensional table of the data or table with columns and rows. That is a two-dimensional table containing rows and columns. Data is organized in the form of table containing rows and columns. The structure of the relation can be represented by the name of relation followed by the name of attribute separated by comma enclosed in a parenthesis. Let employee is the name of relation or employee is the name of table followed by name of attribute that is enclosed in a parenthesis, and all of these attributes are separated by comma. That is the basic structure of the relational data model. And relational data model, we see that we are having the, like here we are having one relation or one table. Table and relation, both of these are the alternate terminologies. Table name is here branch. Containing the different set of attributes, branch number, street, city, and postal code, and having set of the rows, first row, second, third, fourth, fifth, five different rows and four different attributes are there. Relation is a table with column and rows. When we say the word relation, relation is a table. That is the alternate name of the table. We can use the word relation, table, or field, or file. All of these are the same things. Relation is represented by the two-dimensional table in which the row of the table corresponds to the individual record, and the columns that is used to represent the attributes. Like here in branch, we are having the attributes are there: branch number, street, city, and postal code. All of these are the properties of the branch. So all of these are the attributes. Each column represents the attribute. When we see that we are having the attributes are there, attribute can be in any order, and the relation will still be the same relation. Let if we are having the postal code at the second position and street at the last position, or city at first one position and branch code is at the last one position, still relation convey the same meaning. Attribute are the intentions of the database. Mean whenever we have to define the structures, attribute is the intention of database. When we define the structure of any table, so at that time we have to define the attributes. These are the attributes. So attribute is the intention of the database. When we see that we are having the attributes, for attribute defining the attributes, domain is very important concept. What is a domain? A set of allowable value for one or more attributes. Let we are having attribute is here branch number. Name of this one is branch number. And allowable value, we see that character should be there. Size of this one must be 4 digit. Range is B001 to B999. Similarly, street, that is another attribute. For this one, data type is character. Size of this one we see at 35. Then here we are having the salary, that is maximum seven digit range, and the range is from 6,000 to 40,000. Every attribute in a relation is defined on a domain. Domain may be distinct for each attribute, or two or more attributes may be defined on the same domain. It may be possible two different attributes are having the same domain, are defined on the same domain. While there is a possibility that attribute may have a distinct attribute may be distinct for each domain may be a distinct for each attribute. So domain is a set of allowable value for any attribute. Now previously we said that we are having concept of attribute. Attribute we said that column of the relation. That can be in any address, and that is the intention of database. Now, next one, we are having the concept of the tuple. Here we are having tuple, that is a row of any relation. Let one row is available over here, B005, street to Fort Road, city airport record, values are there. So this one is a tuple. Each row containing the values and one from each attribute. Now, here we are having the different values are there, but we are having only one value for the branch number in row 1. And we are having another value, to Fort Road in row 1 for the column street. You see, each row containing the value and one for each attribute. Now, previously what we say about the attribute can be in any order, and relation still be the same relation. Now, again same, tuple can be in any order. If we take this one, first one row, and shift it to the end, our last one row move to the next, second one. So what will be happen? Still relation will convey the same meanings. That will not affect the meaning of the relation. So here in this one relation, we are having the 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 different tuples are there. Tuples, row or record are the same thing, are alternate terminologies. When we see that we are having the tuple, that is the extension of the database. We can add any number of the records. We have to define attribute once. That is the attributes or column are the intention of the database. Branch number, street, city and postal code. We define these attributes just once. And then we can add any number of the rows. So tuple or row or record, that is the extension of the database. Attribute is the intention of the database, tuple is the extension of database. Next one concept is degree of relation or table. When we say, the word we are using, that is a relation or table. Tuple in a relation, attribute in a relation. The number of attribute in a relation or a table, that is called degree. If relation containing only one attribute, then the degree of that one relation is called unary relation. Or that one relation is called unary relation. If relation with two attributes, that is called binary relation. If relation with three attributes, that is called ternary. And if we are having the n attribute, then we can consider it. Now, cardinality degree is related to the number of attributes, while cardinality is related to the number of row in a relation or table, the number of tuples in a table. As we say that when we say degree of relation, degree is the property of intention of the database, while cardinality is the property of extension of the database relation. Cardinality of a relation change when tuples are added or deleted. When we add one new record, one new tuple, one new row in a table, then cardinality will be changed. If we are having the table that contains the 10 different records, so it means cardinality of the relation is 10. If we are having relation that contains the four different attributes, so degree of this one relation is 4, while five different tuples, so degree cardinality of this one relation is 5. If we add the new record, 10 new records, then 5 plus 10, 15, so total number of the record will be 15. So cardinality of this one relation will be 15. So we see that changes occur in cardinality very frequently when user add or delete the tuples in a table or relation. We already say that we are having the different alternate terminology for the relation. We can use the word relation, table or file. For the tuple, we can use the word row, record or tuple, and attribute we say that column or field. Now at the start we say that database relation are based on the mathematical relation. In mathematical relation we are having the concept of the Cartesian product. Let we are having the two different sets are available, D1 and D2. In D1 we are having the two different record, we are having the 2 and 4. D2 we are having 1, 3 and 5. So what we have, when we have the concept of the Cartesian product, so in Cartesian products 2 1 2 3 2 5, then 4 1 4 3 and 4 5. It may specify whenever we are having the mathematical relation, that may specify which pairs are in the relation using some common some condition for the selection. Let me say that display, what is the mathematical relation? We say that relation that containing initial first one domain is 2. So we are having 2 1 2 3 and 2 5. Our range is 1 2 1 and 4 1. So what we have, we say where whenever we are having range value is 1, y is equal to 1, that is 2 1 and 4 1 value will be there. Another relation, that is a mathematical relation. Or the value of x is equal to 2y, we may have another relation. X is first one value and y is the second one value. That is the mathematical relation. So in mathematical relation, we are using the concept of domain and range. But what we are having in mathematical relation, we see that whenever we are having the concept of the mathematical relation, order of the domain and range is very important. That if you want to change it over here, 2 1 and 1 2, both of these are not same. 2 3 and 3 2, both of these are not same. But in mathematical, in database relation, we see that order of row and column is not important. So what is a relation? Relation is a table with column and rows. Relation is represented as two-dimensional table. Now we are having some main common properties of the relation. So what, each relation in database must have a unique name. Whenever we are having the database relation is there, the name of relation must be unique in a database. In one database, we are having the database name, database relation name must be unique. That in when we see that we are having the one database that is related to HR, in that one, if we are having one relationship, relation name is here EMP, so that must be unique in HR schema, HR database. No, we may not be able to repeat this one names. As we said, entity type in conceptual schema, we said that entity type name must be unique for within an organization. Same for the name of the relation, that must be unique. Each relation having the attribute, and every attribute must have an atomic value. Right. We see that whenever we are having attribute is there, attribute must have atomic value. Atomic value means on the intersection of each row and column, we must have a single value. It means no multi-value attribute is allowed in a relation. We are talking about the relation. And relation, we see that name of relation must be unique. Relation must have atomic value, no multi-value attribute. If we are having table, in table we may have multi-value attribute, more than one value on the intersection of each row and column. But in database relation, we are having the atomic value on the intersection of each row and columns. Multi-value attribute is not allowed. Each row must be unique. Whenever we are having database relation, in database relation, we see that row must be unique. Two different rows that cannot have exactly the same value for all their field in a relation. Again, if we are having any table that containing the two different row that are 100% same, exactly same, all the values are the same, it means that is not a relation. So for the relation, that is the common property. The row must be unique. Another attribute in a table must have a unique name. The name of attribute must be unique. Row must be unique. Same row can't be repeated in a relation. Same for the attribute name must be unique. Still now we say that the name of relation is unique. Attribute is unique. Row is unique. And attribute must have an atomic value. No multi-value attribute is allowed. Another, order of the column must be irrelevant. Have no significance. We may have any order of the columns. At first column, we move it to the end. Last column will be moved to the first position. So, order of the column must be irrelevant. And next one, order of the tuple have no significance. Same, row order has no significance. Row can be in any order and still convey the same meanings. So these are the main six properties of the relation. I am again repeating, the name of relation must be unique, name of attribute must be unique, row in a relation must be unique, order of the column have no significance, that is irrelevant. Column or attribute may be in any order. Similarly, we are having the tuple, order have also no significance and still have the same meaning. And last one, every attribute value must be atomic. No multi-value attribute is allowed. Next one, what is the difference? Now we are having question, what is the difference between the database relation and mathematics relation? So when we say that we are having the mathematic relation, we are having domain and range. The order of domain and range is very important. That we are having pair 2, 1 and 1, 2, both of these are not same. While in mathematical relation, if we change the order of attribute or the order of row, that still convey the same meaning. That will not affect the relation. Another, what is the difference between table and database relation? Although we see that these are the alternate terminologies, the difference is that in table we may have multi-value attribute, in table we may have duplicated row, but in relations in a relation atomic value, that is the main property, basic property. And secondly, we see that same row can't be repeated, no duplication exists, no row must be 100% same, completely same, that is not allowed. So that is the difference between table and relation. In next video we will discuss the concept of the different relational key. Thanks for watching the video.